Greenpeace has been in Papua New Guinea's Gulf province documenting the disturbing impacts of logging in the region. In addition to highlighting environmental impacts, our visit also revealed the dramatic human costs of logging in PNG. The people we spoke to, local landowners, workers, teachers, all testify to the exploitation and dislocation that comes hand in hand with logging. While logging companies say they are bringing development to these areas, we discovered quite a different story.
We work for them as slaves, but we sweat our guts in order to have finance for our families.
These workers operate the chainsaws for Turama Forest Industries, one of the major logging companies in PNG. Foreigners do most of the skilled work, while PNG nationals, usually paid a pittance for long hours, do more dangerous work. Often, the logging companies fail to supply their workers with even the most basic safety equipment, such as shoes and gloves, despite the hazardous nature of the work.
No gloves, no helmets, no overalls. Anything like shoes. We don't have safeties for safety purposes, safety wise. When we complain to the management or to the bosses, they tell us that you want to work or you want to finish. The management, our supervisors, deprive our rights, which we have the rights to complain for our salaries. And that's what the company's treatment towards the employees is like today.
Greenpeace obtained copies of payslips from two logging concessions run by Rimbunan Hijau, a Malaysian-based logging company. The records show workers were paid very little money for long hours.
The workload itself, you'll find out that it's very big. And someone who's doing that work should be paid so much because he risks his life also.
Many of the workers are brought in from other areas and have no local fishing or hunting rights. This means they have no option but to buy food and other goods on credit at the company canteen, often at inflated prices. The credit is then deducted every time they get paid, leaving them with very little to live on until next pay.
All is recorded. So once when I get my pay, all this money will go back to that credit. And then I'm left with only maybe 10 kina, 15 kina. And then you think another 2 weeks, I'm going to survive with that money. And that money is just only one day finished. The next day when I get up and go for work and my family is getting hungry, we have to go back and credit again. They work very hard. They get the money from them and they go back and give it back to them.
Trapped in a debt cycle with logging companies, many don't have enough money to pay for transport to leave the area, leaving them no other option but to keep working. Until these serious concerns about forest management and exploitation are addressed, the PNG government must introduce a moratorium on granting logging concessions and extensions in PNG, and conduct a review of all current logging operations. Australia and other importing countries must urgently restrict the importation of illegal and destructive timber. Governments should establish a forest fund for climate protection to stop global deforestation, promote biodiversity, and ensure that the rights of indigenous and local peoples are fully respected, and ensure that they participate in and benefit from carbon financing.